Okay, and as this investigation, of course, expands into a more involvement of maybe a lot of Philippine officials, I'd like to quote a Rappler article quoting PAGCOR saying a cabinet official, a former cabinet official, in fact, has been behind the lobbying for the operations of these illegal POGO operations. I don't know if you can share more information about that with us right now.
I would defer to PAGCOR
okay.
as to whom, who that particular former cabinet official is, given that we've had no interference whatsoever from any official, both current and previous. So I guess at the end of the day, in a day or two, I hope, PAGCOR would illuminate
announce.
Us, enlighten us as to who this particular individual is, so that he or she could become part of our ongoing investigation as well.
So as of now, this individual is not yet part of your investigation, but are you looking at some links? What are the possibilities that this person is in fact involved in lobbying or pushing for the operations of these illegal businesses?
So, Stanley, we'd have to wait for PAGCOR to provide to us the documents or testimonial evidence that they have in relation to the said former cabinet official. But once we do have that information on hand, something that we could take action on, then we will leave no stone unturned. But as of this moment, we have nothing on anybody in relation to any possible interference by a former cabinet official.
Okay, lastly, Winston, and before we go, on another story from the PAOK, this is involving the supposed land acquisition, the massive land acquisition by foreigners in Nueva Ecija and Palawan. What more can you share with us about this, and perhaps what is the kind of collaboration that you will be having with concerned government agencies as regards these stories?
Stanley, this disturbing phenomenon is not a new phenomenon. Mm. We've seen this as far, we've seen this as far as Cagayan Valley. We've submitted a report to concerned agencies in relation to some huge tracts of land being allegedly bought by foreign nationals in areas such as Palawan, Nueva Ecija, and Cagayan. Cagayan Valley in the north. And we've made those reports and submitted them in as much as we're kind of anxious as to their real intention. Mm-hmm. As our good Undersecretary Gilbert de la Cruz stated in a previous interview, this could possibly affect our food security if they, at the end of the day, be able to control the prices of our basic commodities, mm-hmm. such as our basic staple, rice. But more than food security, I'm pretty certain that this would also affect our national security, because some of the lands that are being bought by foreign nationals appear to be located near, adjacent to enhanced defense cooperation agency sites, ETCA sites. So we have to take a look at them seriously, that is.
And lastly, of course, before we go, Winston, we just want to ask you about the assets that you've seized in some of your recent raids. What is going to happen to these assets, properties, even the vaults, the contents of the vaults? Will this be forfeited to the government now?
Yeah. Now, with regards to the vaults, all of them have been submitted in our return of the warrant, so they would form part of evidence, so to speak. Then later on, if the case, as the case progresses, we would file civil forfeiture in relation to all of those monies and other valuables that we have found in all of the raids that we have conducted.
Okay.
In relation to real estate properties, Stanley, the AMLC will file the appropriate civil forfeiture so that once we forfeit them, it will go to our national treasury.
All right, Mr. Winston John Casio, we do hope to touch base with you again for more updates on these developing stories. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Stanley. Have a good day.
All right.